What is attachment? Can you explain with an example? The mind is a product of time. Anything and everything in the mind is in terms of time. The mind takes time as real. So whatsoever exists for a long length of time in the mind takes it as real. And becomes attached to it. The mind says, oh, this is real. If it is real, then it is me. The mind is an incompleteness waiting for completion. It requires some object. Which object would it prefer? It would prefer an object that makes it feel secure, and hence it would prefer an object it can call as real. For the mind, real is always in terms of time. The mind has no other way of determining whether something is real. Don't you say, oh, it has been continuing since 2000 years, how can it be false? Have you not heard such things? I don't think you have heard such things. Have you heard such things? Huh?
Yes.
This temple is 5000 years old. It must be a very respectable temple. For the mind, time is a certification of truth. Which means that whenever the mind is in contact with something for a long period of time, the mind will get identified with it, and that is attachment. Whatever you are with for a long period of time, you start feeling a relationship with that. That is attachment. The kind of relationship you feel depends on your mental configuration. If you are with 10 things, your relationship with the 10 would depend on your conditioning. But what is certain is that as time passes, that relationship will deepen. Attachment. You can get attached even to a small damp spot on a wall in your room. Every day you go to sleep, you lie on the bed, and before you sleep, you watch that damp spot for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and you have been habituated to watching it for 6 years. Now if you have to leave that room and settle somewhere else, you cannot sleep. Why can't you sleep? I need that. Where is my spot? Without watching that, I can't sleep. Attachment. Just time is needed. Which means that if you take time out of the equation, attachment is gone. That shows the very impotency of attachment. And that also shows the absurdity of attachment. If you can be made to live with dry dung, it keeps coming back to us, for a long period of time, you'll be attached to it. If you can be made to live with a certain idea, belief, image with a long period of time, if you can be made to live with any person for a long period of time, then you'll be attached to that person, doesn't matter how rotten that person is. That is how most arranged marriages succeed. You live with someone for a few years, you get so adjusted that even if he kills you, violates you, tortures you, rapes you, you still don't complain. In fact, you say, oh my, this is what the relationship is about. You say, this is the definition of relationship. There's a right upon me. Isn't that obvious in my blissful wildness? You have been living with yourself since the longest period of time. Now do you see the kind of attachment you have with yourself? Since day one, if you have known something, it is the I. You see how you would be clinging to it? That is attachment. To think that you know something just because you have spent time with it, that is attachment.
Is attachment, you did it excellently to find it, but is it bad or is it good?
What does it do to you? All good and bad are always in your own context. What does attachment do to you? If it causes you grief, it is bad. If it lets you be in joy, then it is good. What does attachment do to you? So you know. Why did you ask this question then?
I just wanted to hear what you said.
You just want to have fun at my expense, right?
Yes.
It's strange how simple the answers are and how you already know the answer better than I ever can. Whatever I say to you is not a patch on what you already know.